Hi guys, I'm ICELANDIC here, giving you the third commentary in, if you would like to call it the series, but we're actually going to look at my stat report first of recent times. As you can see, I've actually got about 154,000 kills now, and obviously the deaths are higher, and the game plays 51 days. And I've played the game a lot, and as you can tell, it's probably one of the most on my friends list, but it's because basically I've played it since the game was released. And I've had a lot of free time, but I'm good at managing my time between friends and gaming. So, and they're fine with it. I see my friends a lot, and I get to game a lot, as you can see. That's what happens when you have a lot of free time, as some of you could probably relate to. But also, my kill to death ratio is 0.96, and if I'm honest, that doesn't bother me a single bit. You can say what you like about that, and you won't affect me whatsoever, because I sometimes go out to games and just kill myself the whole game for shits and giggles. I love doing stuff like that, but this is the top of the leaderboard, showing the people that do play it too much. But you think I play a lot? Look at this guy, 114th in the world, Rambo 9386, 200 days, my god, get some fresh air, go out of the house, go for a walk, you know, just ridiculous. Someone had to play. I worked out that was almost like 7 hours a day since the game was released. And that's a lot of time. I mean, come on. But anyway, there's a lot of gameplay around, so and I'm guilty of playing a lot of gameplay. So don't bother me too much. You won't offend me what you say about that. But anyway, I'm gonna play a game of Headquarters, and not one of my favourite game types. But if you want to rank up, I mean, and you want to get some marksmans if you're still ranking up, Headquarters is the gameplay to go to. We've got a game in Overgrown, and. What are your thoughts on Overgrown? Is it a map you skip? Is it a map you think, oh, I might do it, might not? It's or is it a map you just love? I don't know, you might love this map, it might be your favourite. But I think it's good for Headquarters. There's lots of grass, and there's a house or two, there's a barn. No, seriously, on a serious note, a lot of people tend to play tactically on this game. And you can see, I like to snipe on this map. And you can properly snipe rather than having to quickscope all the time and go all guns in blazing. Or pick up my favourite gun, the G46E, and I get a bunch of hit markers. Yay! And I get the assist just to rub it in my face even more. But no, but I like to use the sniper on this map, usually, or an M16 is that gun I use. But you can hardscope people in a random lobby and you won't get hate mail, which you usually get if you don't quickscope people.
You didn't quickscope me, yeah.
Oh, shut up, come on, it's a game. Grow up. Christ, if I've been scoping at you, you've been doing the same to me. If I did it quicker, surely I scoped you quicker. Work it out, use your brain. Anyway, that's my rant for that. But I'm going to go off topic again, as I usually do, and I'm going to talk about my new lifestyle. I don't live in my log cabin anymore, as you saw the setup video. I actually have moved into a place called Lewes, which is in East Sussex, and because I've gone to Brighton University. And Lewes isn't too far from Brighton University, it's a two-stop train ride. And it's fantastic, it's a lovely town, staying with lovely people. It's I'm lodging basically, so I rent a room and I use the facilities in the house as my own sort of thing, with respect for the people that actually own them. But it's good, I'm enjoying it, and I have to commute to Brighton by train. And it cost £87.54 for a monthly train ticket for two chuffing stops. Two stops. And there are people, and the country, what they're trying to do is get people to use public transport, like buses and trains. But if it's going to cost an arm and a leg, why are people going to be obliged to be using public transport when they can just get in their already paid for cars? And, or, you know, someone else's car, you know what I mean? And you can drive where you like, when you like, how you like. But train goes, or a bus has a route, and it stops at a stop, and you have to walk probably 10 million miles to get to where you actually want to go when you get off the train station. It's just so, and you're paying for that, and it's too expensive, and the government, you know, I'm complaining. The government are trying to, you know, like, encourage the people of the United Kingdom to use public transport. But if it's too damn expensive, and even being a student, it was damn expensive, they're not going to get people wanting to use it, and people are still going to use their cars and destroy the universe. Anyway, that's my rant also on trains and public transport. Anyway, I'm studying at Brighton University. I'm doing a course called Environmental Hazards,
which basically is the cool side to geography. You remember going to geography lessons and you were like, oh, I want to learn about volcanoes, earthquakes, tornadoes, hurricanes. Well, actually, that's what I'm doing. And it's basically the cool side of geography, and I'm just learning how then storms and etc. affect people in the world. And it's really cool. Get to go to Greece to look at some rocks, which is going to be fun. But I get to go to Greece, so joke's on you guys. Unless you're going on holiday, please answer back to that comment. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I've made a whole group of friends, fantastic people. I came down to Brighton University last week with basically the people I knew at school, and I knew three of them. And since then, since the first day, I haven't seen these people from my old school at all. And it's because I've made such a big social network already down at Brighton University. It's so good down here. But that's my advice is to people going to university this year or next year. Is that if you're going to university, you don't know anyone, don't worry. You're going to meet loads of new people and it'll all be hunky-dory. It'll be fantastic. You'll love it. So don't worry about not making friends, because you will do. I definitely 100% sure you'll make new friends and you'll love it. So I've actually finished Freshers Week now, which, if you don't know, is a week where you basically get introduced to the uni and you make friends and you go out and you get lashed and, you know, you just like nights out and stuff like that. So now I've actually got to work, which you do at university, which is some people don't even realise. You actually have to work. But the workload hasn't been high yet, but I'm sure it'll come tough, and I probably won't be on Xbox as much. But actually, I'm making this commentary because I got a lot of questions all of a sudden. I got three questions saying the same thing in the space of, 2 days? Which is quite bizarre. But it was, what got you into recording? Why did you buy a capture card? Why did you find it so interesting? And a lot of answers to that question, for many other people, is that, oh, I saw other people doing it and I wanted to record my gameplay, which is fine. I have nothing against that at all. That's great. It's a hobby which people like doing. But my story, oh wait a minute, fail nade. Yeah, right, I've got to change up the tone of this commentary now. My actual story behind me getting a capture card is a lot more sadder than anyone would expect. Actually, in 2005, my granddad had Alzheimer's disease, and he was 89 years old. And we put together some old clips of him and the good times sort of thing into a video. And when we all sat down to watch it with him, the video went bust. It didn't work. The recorder didn't work. So I said, look, I'll get this sorted. I'll see if there's a way I can record what's on the video and put it to a disc, and we can watch it in a DVD player. So I went out, obviously found a very old capture card. It's the first one I ever had. It was a crappy one. It didn't do very good quality, but it did what I needed to do. So I recorded the VHS onto the laptop, onto the DVD. But unfortunately, 2 days after I made the DVD for my granddad to watch, he was submitted to hospital because his disease got too much for our family to look after him. And actually, a week after that, sadly, he passed away, which is quite a sad story in itself. But I was then left lumbered with a capture card, and I thought, well, I don't know what to do with it. So 6 months later, I thought, oh, I'll tell you what I'll do. I've started playing Xbox. I thought I could record gameplay, and that's what I did. I started recording Gears of War, Halo, etc., etc. And that's your answer to how I got a capture card. So hopefully that's cleared a few minds up of how I actually got recording. It's a unique story, but that's how it happened. Anyway, that's gone now, so that's all past. I'm not looking for sympathy, because if I wanted sympathy, I would have told this story a long time ago. Basically, we won the headquarters, 250-20. Fantastic game. I played really well with the R700, I thought, and the crap team anyway. But just to make sure, again, people are watching the video, please leave a comment saying your favourite map and why you like that map, and it's up to you and everything. So rate, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys for another commentary later. Icelandic is out.